This is my M4 MacBook Air, and that's my M4 Mac Studio. And these two Macs stay perfectly in sync. So no matter which one I want to pick up and start working on, or if I've been in my studio and need to take my work on the go, I know I have all the apps, files, footage, everything I need, no matter which computer I'm working on. So in this video, I'm going to show you how I keep these two Macs in sync, all the apps that are syncing over iCloud to make sure I have everything on both, my workflow with Final Cut, which gets a little tricky with footage, how I utilize Safari profiles across both machines, and answer the question, why do I have two Macs? Why not just use my MacBook Air and plug it into a studio display? Let's tackle that one first. So first of all, I make a lot of video content, not only recording videos with multiple cameras, I'm using a video switcher, I have a preview monitor off to my side, but I also do a lot of live webinars. And when it comes to connecting peripherals to a computer, I use every port on the Mac Studio. I did a whole video about me upgrading to the M4 Max Mac Studio. I'll link it above and down in the description. But having all the ports, being able to connect my audio interface, video switcher, external SSDs, and more is critical for most of my workflows. So the Mac Studio is the workhorse. And while I could plug in multiple peripherals to the studio display, I do use the power of the M4 Mac Studio, especially when I'm doing transcriptions of audio, exporting multiple 4K videos, and running multiple instances of Riverside when I'm doing a webinar. But aside from that major video production type work, I want to be able to do everything on either computer at any time. That means accessing all the same files, using all the same apps, making sure they're in sync, and when I travel, I can take my M4 MacBook Air and I know I have everything I need. So the first major element of keeping them in sync is iCloud. I don't use Dropbox or Google Drive on any of my Macs. I sync everything via iCloud. So when you use iCloud on your Mac, it syncs your desktop and document folders. So basically what I've done is put everything in the documents folder. Anytime I create a folder for anything, whether it's work or personal, everything goes into that documents folder. Now iCloud does an okay job of optimizing the Mac storage. So even though I have terabytes of data in iCloud, it's not all coming down to my computer at once. That means I can access any of these files anywhere. Now the only thing I don't put in iCloud is when I'm recording raw audio or importing video footage. I put that in the movies folder because this is not synced to iCloud. So screen recordings like I'm doing right now with CleanShot X, any renders, I'll actually render it to this movies folder rather than sync it to iCloud. And all the audio I'm recording with Audio Hijack locally on this Mac, that goes in that movies folder and it is per computer. But once I render something out and I have that final video file, I have a network attached storage. And basically I have a folder that I can access from either Mac, both for work and personal, and I'll upload those final renders to that network attached storage so I can access them again from either computer. Also, when it comes to the sidebar and finder, I keep that matching exactly the same. I'm running macOS Tahoe here on my MacBook Air, so it looks a little different, but you'll see all the same folders here in the left-hand sidebar on my MacBook Air. And if I go into one of these folders, like Bearded Teacher, I have all the same folders and files on either Mac, and I can download anything I need. And a key folder that I have here in my iCloud drive, something I call a backup folder. And in here I have things like my Blackmagic A10 Mini Pro config file, and that's syncing via iCloud. I have all my Audio Hijack sessions saved in here from way back when. This way, if I install Audio Hijack, I can import them quickly. And I'm gonna get to all the apps that are syncing between both Macs in a second. My compressor settings, so I can quickly import these if I reinstall. Things like my HomeKit codes, which I use HomePass to back all of those up regularly. I back up my shortcuts using a shortcut. That's all in iCloud Drive, so on and so forth. Another benefit of having everything here in iCloud Drive is when I make a thumbnail for one of my videos, that syncs to my thumbnails folder in Bearded Teacher. And then if I wanna post these on social media to promote the video, I don't have to remember to airdrop the thumbnail to myself, or if I sent it to my iPhone, I have the same iCloud Drive folders here on my iPhone or my iPad, and I can access all of those thumbnails, download them in a second, and then share it on social media. And if for any reason I wanted to access those longer form videos that I saved to my network attached storage, I can connect to those right here in the Files app on my iPhone as well. I can go to the home folder and I have access to all those video files right here from my phone or iPad. If I want, I could download, save it to my camera roll, maybe make some clips while I'm traveling, all from my phone. And because I'm running all the same apps on both Macs, things like creating a thumbnail with Pixelmator means I can make a change here on my Mac Studio and pick it up on my MacBook Air. So here's a thumbnail I was working on my Mac Studio. I'll make a change like removing the iOS 26 logo. And then when I save this Pixelmator file here on my Mac Studio, I can quit it here. Here in my MacBook Air, I can go to that same iCloud file. You can see it even updated to say it was changed today. I'll open it, and now that iOS 26 is gone here as well. So even my working thumbnail Pixelmator document stays in sync between the Macs. Not to mention if I ever have both Macs close by, It's easy to use Universal Control to control my MacBook Air, then just drag the mouse over at my Mac Studio, and I'm controlling my Mac Studio. Or I can use my Magic Mouse. Yes, I still like Magic Mouse. I can control the Mac Studio, drag it all the way to the right, and then I'm controlling my MacBook Air with that same mouse. Now, in order to be able to do all my same workflows from my Mac Studio or MacBook Air, I need to have all the same apps installed on both. So I really try to install as many apps as possible through the App Store. Apps like Things, my to-do app, Sofa for keeping track of my movies and TV shows, Screens, my VNC app, Fantastical, Pixelmator, all of that is through the Mac App Store. So updates stay in sync, and when I have a new Mac, I can quickly install them from here. I won't go through every app I have installed. I did an entire video on the 35 apps I install on every new Mac. You can watch that video here and down in the description. But if I open Launchpad here on my Mac Studio, and there's no more Launchpad in macOS Tahoe, but I can go to the app view here in Spotlight, and you see I have all the same apps installed on both, whether it's Bear, Call Sheet, Data Jar, which also syncs over iCloud and I use in Shortcuts, Transcriptionist, and many of these apps also sync via iCloud, or Fantastical, which syncs through its own account service. I know the changes are happening on both Macs at the same time. Even to the point of I try to have the same menu bar icons in both computers. Apps like Pastebot, which gives me my clipboard history, and I'll still be using it even with macOS Tahoe, because the clipboard history in Tahoe expires after 8 hours. Pastebot saves my clippings up to 500 or even 1,000, and there's no time limit. I also have Audio Hijack on both computers, and I can always import my other sessions with that iCloud backup folder. I have Text Expander running on both Macs. Of course, Fantastical is running on both. That all syncs via iCloud. And I do have a couple apps specific to the Mac Studio. One of them is Companion, which allows me to use my Stream Deck to change my Blackmagic A10 Mini Pro. Bit of a long story there. I also have Screens 5 Connect running in the background so I can VNC into this Mac Studio whenever I need. And my password app, which I have completely switched to iCloud passwords, that lives in the menu bar for both, and those stay perfectly in sync. And now with macOS Tahoe and iOS 26, you actually get password version history. I'll talk about that in my macOS 26 features video. I'll link that above. And my iOS 26 100 plus new features is coming soon, so get subscribed. That video is going to be coming out with the public beta. And then, of course, apps like Bear, which I literally have running here on Mac Studio as the outline for this video. Everything stays perfectly in sync, and Bear is rock solid. I'll even make a change here on my MacBook Air. Let's say, watch this. A few seconds, you'll see it appear here in my Bear Note on my Mac Studio. You'll also see on my MacBook Air, right now I'm in my filming focus mode, silencing notifications, and those focus modes sync as well, so I'm in filming here on my Mac Studio. One thing I do wish is that focus filters would actually sync when you sign into your iCloud account. But because you might have different email accounts or calendar apps installed on your different Macs, you do have to go in and actually set the focus filters per computer or per Mac. So I actually have to go into Fantastical, actually make sure that the right calendar set is set for this focus mode, but at least the focus mode turning on and off is synced across all my Apple devices. Now I'll talk more about my Final Cut workflow in a second, but one of the things about video workflows, whether you use Premiere, DaVinci, or Final Cut, is plugins can be a challenge, especially using across multiple computers. That's why I get all of my plugins, though listen, this is not a sponsor, they've never given me money, but I use MotionVFX for all of my Final Cut plugins, like little animations, even little subscribe tags like this, the zoom ins and the zoom outs, which is from MKBHD's pack. And you can install all your MotionVFX plugins on two devices. And so basically I have all the same plugins installed here on my Mac Studio as I do on my MacBook Air. So if I bring a Final Cut project from one to another, all the plugins stay the same. Anything I've edited in a project is good to go. And MotionVFX makes it really easy to install and uninstall or move between Macs. One other thing before I get to my Final Cut workflow, I have gotten into Safari profiles a lot. I have a profile for the podcast, Primary Technology. That's my weekly podcast with Jason A. Tim, subscribe above. Beard FM, which is like my personal and video stuff. My work for Riverside, I have a Safari profile for that. And what I love is in the Safari preferences, you can actually set a specific tab group that opens when you open that profile for the first time. So if I go to open a new window in my Beard FM profile, it will automatically open all the tabs that I have set right away. And you can do that by going to your bookmarks. Basically what I've done is create a folder for each profile. And then in each folder, I have the group of websites that I want to open anytime I open a new window in this profile. And it's the same thing when I open a new profile for Primary Tech, which side note, if anybody from Apple's watching, sometimes it just opens up all of my bookmarks when I open a new window, not just the profile ones. So I have to go back to Safari settings, go to the profile, just click the same thing I had checked. And now when I open a new window for that profile, magically now it's just the tabs that I wanted. But even things like tab groups stay perfectly in sync. So for Primary Tech, I have a tab group for every episode. This is where I can go back, and these were all the links that we discussed during the episode. You see, I have all the episodes all the way back, and those tab groups sync even to your iPhone, iPad, and another Mac, like my MacBook Air here. I can open a new primary tech window, but you'll see all the tab groups, the same ones are synced here. I think even the active tab that I had selected the last time I opened this tab group. And so I can record an episode from my MacBook Air, my Mac Studio. I still have all the resources I need. Two more quick things before I get to Final Cut. I do use Hazel here on my Mac Studio, and I use it on a Mac Mini that I have a whole workflow running, both for smart home stuff and for some Plex things. But I don't have Hazel running on my MacBook Air because I'm not typically doing automated file moves. But once I have macOS Tahoe on all my Macs, I might be moving those to the shortcuts automations, because you can do a lot of the same things now with built-in shortcuts, watching folders, moving files automatically. So get subscribed, because I'm going to show what workflows I use once Tahoe is out for everyone. But if you want an early preview, I show a few really cool shortcuts you can use with those folder automations and Apple Intelligence in this video here. And also, like I said, I have Screens VNC running on my Mac Studio. This way, whether I'm traveling or wherever I am in the world, I can open the Screens app on my iPhone or my iPad, or even another Mac, and I can log in and start controlling the Mac Studio. That's literally me VNCing screen recordings all the way down. And if I can access my Mac Studio remotely, that means I can access my network attached servers, my Mac Mini that's also on the same network. The possibilities are endless. Side note, I really think Screens 5 is one of the best for VNC. I can control things like use my iPhone as a trackpad. And you'll see here on my phone, I'm gonna tap and hold with my thumb. I'm moving the window via the Screens app on my iPhone, but you can see it moving on my Mac Studio, which is pretty wild. All right, so how do I do it with Final Cut? Well, the bottom line is I have my entire Final Cut library whenever I'm doing videos, no matter which Mac I'm on, it goes to an external SSD. I use the OWC Envoy Pro FX. There are external Thunderbolt SSDs. I have 1 and 2 terabyte versions, multiple, both for Riverside, my work stuff, and my personal videos. So I can have projects, and I'll just make one right here on my Mac Studio. Maybe I wanted to make a video on the Nothing 3A, which I never got around to, and now the Nothing 3 is out, so I probably won't. But here's the project, there's the timeline, and maybe I need to leave the house real quick because I'm taking my kids somewhere, but I want to keep working on this video. Well, I can just quit Final Cut Pro. I'll eject the external SSD, which for my personal libraries, it's called Arrakis. I want to be real, I think I have some of the best external SSD naming. You can see it right here in the Finder, right? But you'll see my library, which I call BT Working. It's here on the external SSD. I'll just eject it. I've unplugged it. Now I'll just take this with me, and yes, I label my SSDs. And then here, I'll connect the same SSD to my MacBook Air. And if I open Final Cut now on this Mac, I can open the exact same library. I'll go to the same event. Here's my Nothing 3A project, and everything's there. Plus all the plugins that come from MotionVFX, whether it's overlays, slide overs, my little subscribe and like tags, all of it still works here on my MacBook Air, and I can finish editing the project here, export it out, and I can go back and forth between the Air, my Mac Studio, however many times I want, and everything stays in sync. So that's my seamless dual Mac workflow. If you have any questions about my process, apps, or workflow, let me know down in the comments. I'll answer you there. And get subscribed to the channel, hit that like button. Again, more iOS 26 content, plus more shortcuts automations, especially on the Mac once that launches, is coming soon. If you want to get an early look at macOS Tahoe, I'll put my video on that right up here. Or if you want to look at the new features coming to iPadOS 26, I'll put my video to iPadOS 26 right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.